So my lecture is on this data, so on this lecture, exploring and analyzing free optical satellite imagery with Python. You already heard about who I am. Now this lecture will be in three parts. First, general info on optical satellite imagery, where to get and download high resolution free satellite imagery, and working with Python on satellite imagery. This is the most of the lecture. Now, what I'm talking here is optical satellite data, and so there are other type of satellite. Now, satellite image are very much like a camera image that people see in RGB and shown camera, but the satellite image can see in much more band or color. If a human can see in this band, satellite image can see in all of this band. I will talk about the range until the lines. So, and what it give us is the ability to see to smoke, see planet elf, and many more ability. And now, this is an explain from the last year fire in Haifa. In the side of the true color, you see the fire, how it's been photo by the satellite lens at 8. I will soon talk about him. This is how the human eye can see, and you can see the smoke is don't give us to see the fire. In the other side, we can see it with false color. These are color band that the human eye cannot see, and we can see the fire quite good. The other vegetation is another color because this is a band of the human eye cannot see, so it's a little different. And now the two satellites that I will talk about are Lancet group of satellite and Sentinel-2. Lancet satellite are a series of satellite that have good data from this year that written here. It's in a 40 meter resolution and take the photo of the Earth in every place each 16 day. They are free to download from this site of the Earth Explorer. And they also have more data in before the year that write in the text, but is less in good quality. When you look in the Google Earth map from the latest zoom, you see the Lancet data. And the other data is the Sentinel-2 satellite. This is from the European Space Agency. It's been launched a year and a half ago, and you have a resolution of 10 meter each 10 day in every place in the Earth. It will soon be 5 days when the two active satellites will be in orbit. And you can download the data from the Copernicus site. All the data is free for use for any cause. There are many startup and other companies that make use of these two satellites. And you can also download the data from the Lancet and Lancet and Sentinel-2 from the Google Cloud or Amazon Cloud. Now this is a quick explain how do you download the data from the Sentinel-2. You also have a code of Python to download the data automatically that also living in the internet. So you log into the site, it's a free login, and you can, in this explain, look in the polygon of Haifa and download data of Haifa area. I forgot to say, they split the image from the satellite to a lot of small tile in the roof. So, and this is where we are here today. You see, this is Parilan. And this is an image from the Sentinel-2 satellite, 10 meter resolution. One is a true color, how the human eye can see. Another is false color. One of the band is a band that the human eye cannot see, is more sensitive to vegetation. I forgot to say that not long ago, this kind of resolution image will cost you a lot of money. And you also have the ability, of course, to buy commercial satellite data that maximum resolution can be until 40 centimeters. Not in Israel because of our problem. And now when you download the Sentinel-2 data, you get a series of JPEG-2 file. Each file comes in this format. You have the location. This is a code of the location. Each area has another code. The date of the image, and this is not important, and the number of band. Now, if you combine band 2, 3, and 4 to image, you get an RGB image, like a camera C. And from the next slide, I can also convert the data to a GeoTIFF already. The lens data come already in GeoTIFF format. And, okay, this is a satellite data, a 2D array, basically. What unique in them, they have geolocation data to tell where is the satellite is in the world. And also we got metadata that told other properties like the coordinate system and sometime where it is in the world, sometime more data like in which day it was taken and many more. It depends on how the data is coming. And okay, this may be basic, but I put it anyway. We need to work with Python, we're working with satellite data with NumPy. 2D NumPy array is a single band. This in the start we see in the first part we see basically not a 2D array, a 1D array. After that we got two dimensional array. If we combine two dimensional array, stack them together, got a mistake in the image, we can do a multi-band we can do a multi-band or time array. It means we have a raster on raster on raster, and each raster is another date. This is some of the package I will talk. I will talk about this package today, a model. There are many more models exist in the Python ecosystem, but I will not talk about them. And this model in this are a model that are file format that are popular in the geoscience community. But some satellite data can be this format. Now, a basic opening of raster data with a GDAL is like this. I'm importing the code, so importing the model, opening the GeoTIFF, and then I can print the info on them, the X sides, the Y sides, how many band, and which the location on the data on the world. And quite easily, I can read the data set to an NumPy array and do what I want with an NumPy array, like ask where is the value is higher than 0.1, like this explained. Now, a little return to remote sensing from satellite, basically getting image from satellite. Satellite, a very popular ability in remote sensing is to detect vegetation from space. Now, we are using what it's called a normalized difficult vegetation index, it's NDVI. NDVI is the index that I will not get into the scientific part of him, it's later in this side, but it told us that if we got one, we have a maximum vegetation in the pixel. If we have zero, we have no vegetation at all. Between zero and 0.2, it's soil with some thing that can also be green, so they consider vegetation. And below zero, we got water. So in this plane, we see a farming field that also, that the NDVI is not the same in everybody, Because if plant don't get water, the NDVI is getting lower. It's like the sick. Other problem. This is very popular. Many companies in the field of farming use this technique. And if we take a pixel of NDVI in time, we can see that the growing of the plant, and after that it die. This is also a way to look and stuff. Now I'm turning to a steroid. This is a model, I live in GDAL because it's very basic and very not easy to work with him. And turning to a steroid, it's from this auto, and it's come from a company called Mapbox. It is a computer of Google in part of mapping. So I import it in the package, in the first part. In the second, you see I load in image one, it is band four. Band four is the red band. And band, and after that I open in the near band. This is the, in the sentinel it's band eight, near red band. And then I'm, with NumPy I'm doing the math that you see of the NDVI formula to get a result to a map. Now in this map you will see Herzliya from the satellite. In the image you see, it's not the same date, but that's to show, in one part you see a field that is that in the NDVI image you see that you got no NDVI at all. In the city you see two parts, one tree near Herzliya studio and one green area. This is a park with a lot of grass. Now if I will turn another date, you will see the change in the NDVI in the area outside the city. This is because somebody start growing something on the field, and it's very easy to track after the vegetation changing there. In the city, the vegetation is less changing because most of it been taken care of by a human being, so she's not supposed to die. And the area in here is dust. So. And now to the last package of data we'll talk about is the X-ray. X-ray is, you can say, advanced NumPy with a label array. What it gives us the ability, it's also borrow some stuff for Panda. To give us the ability, if in NumPy we need to write the dimension as 0, 1, 2, in X-ray they have a meaning. X, Y, Z can also be X, Y, T. And just generally, so you can also have store metadata. Also a thing that I didn't write in here, so you have the ability to work with more array size, more bigger than that in memory with a desk. This is explain what you can do. And now for the final exam. I'm importing the packages, the model. This is a function that I take from another person that was in Pycon UK. It's because when I wrote the code, the X-ray didn't work so good with raster data directly. So it's give the raster data geolocation data in a good way. And now to the end, to the start, to the final code. I'm importing in I'm choosing the place where the GeoT file exists. In this following function, I'm parsing the string from the data, so we know which data each satellite image will be. Like you see, I already did a series of NDVI raster from Sentinel-2 image. It will be in the south of Israel, and in the last part of the Jupyter notebook, almost last part, I'm putting it stack them as a raster array in time. So it's based again, and we can see that we have 11 raster with the size. So now for the plotting, X-ray is connected to a matplot very, very easily. So I can choose the date, what I cannot do in organal NumPy, as a val. And there you say, plot the raster with real coordinate. This is a UTM coordinate of WH1. I won't get into it. And we can see that in this date, a lot of farming was in the south of Israel. The two parts that in square are Sterot and Netivot, that have not a lot of vegetation because they are a city and don't have a lot of vegetation. And the red part in near the sea is Gaza Strip. If I take another date, we can see that there are much less farming activity, and there's still some green zone. And another date, sorry, not another date. Sorry. Okay. And now for the final part, to use the full ability of X-ray, we need to turn the file into an etcdf4 file. Although I'm not sure it's necessary, but this is what I did. An etcdf4 file is a file format that is very popular in the geoscience community to store large data of climate model. That each, let's say, 1 hour you have a raster data array. So, and you have a lot of raster array in the year, so they use this format that store the data as one file with many array that they also have the metadata with them. So I save it into an etcdf, and now you can see easily that we in the first I can change, you give a default name to my data, so I change it to ndvi. And you can see each data variable, that is basically the array, the NDVI also have X, Y, and time. I can also put that I have more data variable, like rain and more stuff like that. It only need to be in the same size of the raster, of the array. And you can see how easily I can plot a time series on the in the zone. In where I want, this is in this explain, I take air that is only soil, so you can see the NDVI is very low all over the time. And in the next explain, the photo here is just to show it's not exactly the same date. We can see the is increasing NDVI and getting lower. That is somebody got something on them and then stop in the following date. And and also, there are companies that use or resources that use machine learning to identify which crops it is. If you scan enough time series, you can know which crop it is. And this is almost the end. X-ray have, I think, all the ability of NumPy. You can also return the array to a NumPy array. So very easily I can slice the array that is in time, the 3D array in time, and choose the parameter that is NDVI, and do a mean of all the raster. In this part we can see that that we have a lot of tree in this area, because of this is all over the year green. And another one that we can see that if we do the NDVI max like the way before, we get the maximum NDVI all over the year. So we can see that most of the area was used for farming. And the cities still, they are red because they are quite the same. Stay with the NDVI, that is vegetation. And this out. I end early, so now that's hoping it will work. Sorry. Okay, another one. I want to link to a project of Google that showed the chain of the oft in Landsat in Netanya, that showed the Landsat satellite image in Netanya from for 4 years until today. And thus, and one final thing, the European nation, the European Union used the Sentinel-2 for other use, like see how clean is your beach, so because the satellite can also see in band that see the pollution in the sea, it's a way to see if the sea is polluted. So I guess in Israel it's quite healthy with our sense of the beach. And this is it. I'm sorry, this is my first lecture and I was a little nervous. So, question?
Yes.
The question was, how do you know how the clean is the beach? Okay, it's not the maybe it's not the beach, it's the sea in the beach. Okay, so in band, I think 1 and 2 is sensitive to pollution in the beach. So I think band are, so if you look in Sentinel in let's say if we have time. What we go out from the sewer system in Israel or other states is chlorophyll, that is another type of pollution. You can easily detect it in satellite. You can see it easily if you look in a satellite photo of Israel, that we got pollution from the Gaza Strip. So this is another place in Israel that pull pollution and other stuff. Another question? Okay.
Saying I have zero experience in working with satellites with regard to domain knowledge, how would you recommend for someone to start?
I will recommend with the Landsat data because I didn't... Landsat or satellite, there are a lot of guides in the internet, and download the data that is in IGES, that, yes, I will recommend Landsat or Sentinel, go to the website of Earth Explorer or other site and start download the file. It's very, there are a lot of guide in the internet that told us what, that told you how to work with it. Also, a thing that I didn't tell, and it exists, Google have opened their servers in the cloud that have the ability that you can work on him, on all the data on the cloud. It's have a JavaScript IP and a Python IP, so this is the reason I didn't actually say that, but it's give you the ability to work on multi, on a lot of satellite on the cloud of Google free, until they decide otherwise. Another question? Okay, sorry. Oh, yeah.